Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today we are going to be taking a look at five unique music video effects that I just used in my most recent music video with an artist named C. White. I'm really stoked on how the video came out, and I think you guys are going to really enjoy learning about these effects. Let's light this candle right here. Today we got sweater weather. You know, I've been really liking it, so we're going to go ahead and flick the candle on today there. I always like lighting a candle before diving into some video editing. It kind of sets the mood, gets my creative juices flowing. Comment below if you guys have any tips or tricks or maybe some rituals that you do before you start editing to kind of get your mind in the zone. Definitely interested to hear what you guys have to say. Let's get into the tutorial. Got a bunch of different colored markers, and this indicates where the effects that we're going to be breaking down today are. You can create colored markers on your timeline by holding down M when you create a marker, and then you can select the different marker color. So for me, I marked all of those markers in different colors depending on where the different effects were. Kind of helps me stay organized. It also helps me stay organized throughout the editing process. Let's actually check out the first maybe 20 to 30 seconds of this music video so we can get a vibe.
Now we cruising. I hit the block in the morning playing that Gucci. And yeah, I'm waiting for that package, and yeah, it's making me nervous. I'm living my life just like a movie. Yeah, one fucking K, he'll give you will lay. I put my hands in the air like it was Six Flags. Yeah, half a ticket started from a Nick bag. It ain't no books inside of there, that's a brick bag. Ain't no books inside the bag, but these motherfuckin' president. All these bitch steppers in this room sound like elephant. Plain chain, I don't want diamonds in my skeleton. White wine, when we dying, we gon' keep it elegant.
So the artist, C. White, he's definitely got his unique style. I really enjoyed editing this music video. It was really refreshing. The first effect we're gonna be breaking down today is this kind of ripped paper effect that we see here in the beginning. This effect is really trendy, and I've seen it popping up more in a lot of music videos this year especially. People are starting to incorporate kind of that real life texture feel into their digital creations, like these music videos, and I think the combination is really cool. I actually downloaded Bryan Delimata's paper texture pack from his website, which you can check out the link below if you are interested as well. You can see we just have a bunch of really nice scans of these paper textures. Now, if you end up importing any type of PNG or JPEG file into Premiere Pro, it's important to come up here into Premiere Pro preferences, come down to timeline, and just make sure that your still image default duration is something shorter. That way you're not importing pictures and having them be 15 seconds a piece, 20 seconds a piece, if you only want them to last a quarter of a second, or maybe not even that long. So come in here, it's gonna save you a lot of time, and just change the still image default duration to in between probably 2 and 5 for this effect. So let's actually change it to 3. Let's just hold click all of these textures right back into our timeline. So now they're all 3 frames a pop right there. So they're really large compared to the rest of the timeline. All you have to do to shrink these down is highlight all of them, right click on them, and hit scale to frame size. Move this paper texture layer up to about video layer 4. Then what you want to do is click and drag in all those textures, hold option and drag them down. So now we have these textures stacked on top of each other. The ones that sit on video layer 4, all you're going to do is change the blend mode to screen. We're just going to copy paste this opacity to the rest of them, so they're all screen just like that. Go somewhere on your timeline and find some screenshots of what you want to put in these kind of paper frames. So I'm gonna take a screenshot of this frame right here. To do that, I'm just gonna hit this little camera icon, and I'm gonna make sure that it says import into project. Then I'm just gonna hit okay. We're gonna go to our project panel right here. You can see it imports directly. Then all I'm gonna do is click and drag it underneath one of our paper textures right there. All you gotta do to make this freeze frame show through is come to effects. You're gonna type in track matte key, and you're gonna throw a track matte key onto your screenshot. Then you're gonna change your matte to video 3, which is the video layer above it, and now you can see it fits in the rips of the paper texture. So now what I'm gonna do to make it a little bit easier to move this around is just highlight all of these. I'm gonna right click on them and hit nest and hit okay. And then from here, if I just decrease the scale, you can see we can move this ripped paper texture all over the screen if we want to. We can move the position, and it's all gonna stay within the frame. Add a color balance HLS to this nested sequence, and you can kind of wash out some of these colors a little bit and make it look more grainy, film-like. You can add a Lumetri color to this. You can play with the hue of the picture right here, make it different. You know, you can really customize how these frames look. So that's all you have to do to kind of get this effect here. It's just go through your timeline, take a bunch of screenshots, put them under the rip layers, and then add a track matte key. And then you can really just move them wherever, kind of like an animation style. You know, it's almost like stop motion. Like, if you guys are interested in checking out some of these paper textures, definitely check out Bryan's website. I'll include a link to his website down below. This pack is super easy to use. It really only took me a minute to a minute and a half to pick it up. The next effect I want to break down is just this music video intro title that I created. You'll see it kind of ties into the first effect that we just did, the paper effect. So here in the beginning, you can see we have our title pop up with a little glitch effect there in the beginning. And then we also have that paper texture stop motion effect going on behind it. And it just looks really, really cool. I did update the cinematic titles pack on my website. We took it from 25 titles to 40. I've been testing it out on a bunch of my own personal music videos like you just saw there. It's just a really, really convenient way to hook your viewer in the opening seconds of your music video. I took this first title. I thought this was a really cool title, and I thought it would fit the vibe of the rest of the video. Quite a few different styles in this pack, so I tried to include a really nice variety of different title templates. All you gotta do to customize these title templates is just right click on the one you wanna open, or maybe shift click on a few of them. And then what you're gonna do is right click and hit open with Adobe Photoshop. I included these background images to kind of give you a vibe of how this text is gonna look on top of your footage. Let's just open up this main text right here. Go to our type tool. We're gonna click on cinematic right here in the middle. This music video is called Brick Bag, so I just typed in Brick Bag right here. Just changed it up a little bit. Now you can change the color of this. You can tweak it out if you want to. These templates are really just a really nice starting point for adding your own cool cinematic titles to your music videos or your sport edit or whatever it is that you're working on. I'm gonna click on this artist layer. I'm gonna click T, and I'm just gonna change this artist layer. The artist name is C White. So obviously that text is a little bit too big. Let's shrink the size of the text down so it fits. And then what I'm gonna do is just select our C White layer, hold Command T to move it around, and we can just slide it up till it's perfectly behind the title of our music video. So boom, right there. What I can do is close that off. I can open up this corner text folder right here, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I can just click T on my keyboard, and I can just customize all of this text here at the top however I would like to. I can move it around if I want to. The cool part of the cinematic titles pack is I've also included an icon sheet. The icon sheet is perfect because it's really easy to click and drag some of these other designs onto your title templates and customize them even further. So I've included a ton of different icons on this icon sheet that you can put on your own music video titles and get even more creative. Once you've customized your title, all you got to do is turn off the background layer, and that's going to leave us with a transparent background. I'm up here to File, Export, click Export as PNG, and we can save this directly to the desktop. So let's just save this as Title Example. And then back here in Premiere Pro, all you gotta do is click and drag it onto the video layer above your effect layer or your video layer. So that's what I did here. You can see the title layer sitting on top of the footage. And then here in the beginning, I have this little glitch effect happening. And this is just a preset from my Blueprints preset pack. So if I just delete this, we can just recreate this really easily here. So I'm just gonna cut this first part of our title. All I did was I came over to Presets, Blueprints, I went down to Horror right here, and I click and drag that onto my text, and we get this really cool kind of glitch effect. So if I hide the footage layer in the background, you can see what our text layer looks like. Okay, now if I turn the footage layer back on with those effects, it looks really, really sick. So I just loved combining Bryan's paper texture pack with my cinematic title pack to get this look. I think it really made the video hit a lot harder in the beginning. This next effect is super easy to use, and it's really just an overlay. We're gonna be talking about how light leaks can really enhance your music videos. What light leaks are, these little flashes of light right here. You can see it come over the artist right there, and just an overlay. You'll see these in all types of edits, not just music videos. You'll see these in sport edits. You'll see these in cinematic wedding reels. Light leaks are super popular amongst video editors. I've included a few light leaks in my free pack on VenerVisuals.com if you're interested in checking them out and putting some light leaks on your own videos. In this pack of 30, you can see we have a variety of different light leaks that you can put over your footage. And that's exactly what I did here in the beginning of this music video, is I just threw in some light leaks. We can just take this one, number 4. Let's take it and drop it into our timeline on above some of our footage. Our footage isn't showing through yet, so all we gotta do is change the blend mode from normal down to screen. This light leak looks really, really cool with this blue background here with the lights. For me, I like to get a little bit more custom with it, so that's why I use a color balance HLS. Let's drag one of those onto this light leak. Let's change the hue to get a different color light leak if I want to. Or I can take the saturation all the way down so it's more of just this hazy white light leak and not something with a lot of color. Kind of blends in more with the footage. So this one's a blue light leak. You can see this one in full speed here as it plays. Now, some people get really creative with light leaks. One of my subscribers, Beepo, hit me up on Instagram and sent me some footage he used some of my light leaks on, where he actually rotoscoped people in After Effects and had the light leak kind of shining through the rotoscope layer. And I thought that was a really, really cool way to use them. Like I said, if you want some free light leaks, go to my website and download the free pack and try them out for yourself. I thought this next effect was super creative. I thought this video clip looked really cool here. He's dropping the flower, and this is in a couple other clips as well. If I just play it back on loop here, you can see how the flowers kind of duplicate after he drops the first flower, and they all seem to come out of his hand. I got the idea to do an effect like this just because I think the shot is really creative, and I thought it could just use that inch of sauce to just bring it to the next level. Now, my first instinct was to maybe see if I could rotoscope out this flower, but you can see here, there's just not enough detail to do rotoscoping. So the next best option for me was to go to elements.envato.com. And now, you don't have to go to elements.envato.com. You can go to any really stock website where you can find some flower PNGs and just find a flower that looks similar to the one that's falling out of his hand. Or, you know, say he's dropping some money here, you could do the same thing with money. Could be anything. I mean, really any object you can find. I switched it from all items to 3D, and I just looked up rose because I think that's the flower he was dropping. It's either a rose or a tulip. There's all these different 3D models of roses. Now, the cool thing about these 3D models on elements.envato.com is that once you click on a rose here, you can say view 360 render, and you can actually drag the screen around to get an angle of the rose that looks like the angle that you want to use in your edit. So for me, this angle was pretty much completely horizontal right here. What I did from here is I just downloaded a PNG. I right-clicked on this clip and I hit replace with After Effects composition. So this top layer is gonna be our flower layer. If I just hide that layer, you can see we just have the raw clip of the one flower falling out of his hand. Now, if I turn the original clip off and our flower layer on, let's make it a black background so we can see this a little better. You can see that this layer, all it is just these flowers falling. So that's what I did. I just keyframed some position on these flower PNGs and I just duplicated them a bunch of times. So once you keyframe your flowers and you add some motion blur, all you got is an effect that looks like this. And I thought that was really cool. It was really trippy. And now I'll play it back at full speed so you can get the full effect. Just a little visual eye candy that I threw in. The last effect we're gonna learn today is the reverse stutter effect. And I think this effect just goes hard. It makes those fast jittery parts of the song just slap a little bit harder. You're gonna see this effect happen right here on the timeline where these three clips are. So let's check it out. You can hear it in the song. There's like that shaker that happens. Let's just hide the visual for a second. Let's just check out what the song sounds like and just listen for that. And now let's look at it with the stutter effect only, no original footage, so you can really see how it lines up with the beat. And then we turn our original footage layer back on here, and this is what it looks like all together. I think it's a really great way to add some flair to these kind of rapid parts of the song. So what we're gonna do here is just delete those clips off of our timeline. Let's just create this effect from scratch. Just take this first clip right here, the one that we're gonna stutter with, hold option and drag it up to video layer 2. Let's hit command R. We're gonna change the speed to something like 500. And we're also gonna hit reverse speed. And now what we're gonna do is drag this kind of closer to the end there. From here, what I'm gonna do is cut this down even further. So let's just hit C on our keyboard and make a cut right there. And then we're gonna delete this big excess off the end of that. Now what I'm gonna do is just duplicate this first part. So we're just gonna hold option and drag it out 3 times. So we got the same reverse clip playing at 500% speed, duplicated 3 times to get this reverse effect. Let's check it out one more time.
money playing that Gucci. And yeah, I'm waiting for that package, and yeah, it making me nervous. And I'm living my life just like a movie. Motherfucking K, he'll give you a lay. I put my hands in the air like it was Six Flags.
The links for everything used in today's tutorial can be found below in the description if you want to try some of these assets out for yourself and add them to your own music videos. I also have a free pack on my website, venturevisuals.com. Go check out the links down below. I really appreciate this community. I've been very blessed to have a lot of you guys in this community, and just meeting so many of you, seeing your work, connecting with you on Instagram and YouTube has just been an awesome experience. So I want to say shout out to you guys who watch my videos. I really appreciate it. It really makes me smile when I see the same people commenting on multiple videos and liking my stuff, or you know, hitting me up on Instagram. So it's been a great process, and I'm very blessed. I really appreciate everybody who watches and supports the channel. Comment below or hit me on Instagram if you have any questions at all. And until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.